market was down 12% on October 27, 2008. With that, your first CMT charter holder says, thank you.
Thank you, Lawrence, for the very insightful presentation. So our next speaker, his name is Nikki Yu. She has 8 years of industry experience across different roles. She's now with Wealth, previously with COL, and prior to that, ING Private Bank. She was recently the recipient of the Angat Pilipinas Role Choice Award for Financial Literacy in the Philippines through her blog, Faceless Trader. She started Faceless Trader Ground Zero, a Facebook group that is one of the most popular stock market group destinations in the Philippines, and recently co-founded Bukaha, a financial social platform and trading tool used by over tens of thousands of active traders in the Philippines. So, guys, round of applause for Nikki.
Thank you, Mr. Thank you. So, everyone talks about the B-Wave, the October 27 incident. Now we go back to history. We'll talk about what happened during the bear markets of the Philippines so that if it does occur, we are prepared. So what has a market done? How long do bull and bear markets usually last? Based on history, how far do they go and when do they begin to end? What's the actual average valuation during bull markets versus bear markets? What happens when markets become narrow with fewer stocks participating? What does a bad market look like? Was a 20% down a bad market? Can we go to history to know that? What can we learn going forward? And how do we discern value, momentum, or dividend? What does crowd behavior look like in a bear market? And how does volatility fare? These are just some of the questions that I hope that we could answer on this report. Peter Lynch said that you would always face this decline. They're gonna happen, and if you're not ready for that, you shouldn't be in the stock market. The stomach is the key organ here, it's not the brain. So it's behavior. So just as Mr. Gonzaga said, if you look, which I did for the past 30 years in the Philippine stock market, what you could see right now highlighted are those that are very near. We've experienced in June 2013, August 2015, and well, I would be scared in October, but I would also be scared because we have here October, August, June. Well, essentially, September, October, August. You are very afraid, August, September, October. Usually it's very bad, okay? And so if we are in this is just in visuals. We had actually experienced one of the nasty drops this January 11th. We had a down 4% day, but you might recall that August 24, we had a down 6.7% day. These days may be sad for some, but it's a happy day for some people who want to buy during these days, right? Okay, so my question is, did you survive the 2008 bear market? I hope so, we're all here. So during the 2008 bear market, there were 6 large declines, but 5 powerful bear market rallies. And right when I say powerful, they are really powerful. So 3.9 goes down 10% very fast, September to November. Then it goes rally up. Every rally would deceive everyone because each rally is at least 20%. But where was the opportunity of a lifetime? If there is a very powerful bear market rally, this is the opportunity of a lifetime. When stocks actually just range. 1-6-2076, 1-7-2000, 1-8-2030, 1-8-1955, 1753. This is the 6 months where you double, triple, quadruple your money, and the first breakout of the range, by then you're probably 500% up, if you got the lows. Okay, so if everyone said that I missed the low, that's not true. History tells you that you have so many retests and you can catch the lows if you want to. It doesn't happen once. this is your Philippine stock market since 1986, 1985 actually, until the last, I mean the presentation as of March 5. So from a weekly perspective, within 31 years, in my count, we've seen 4 very powerful bull markets and 5 bear markets to remember. 1987 to 88, 89, 90, I think the so-called Black Monday crash, the Chinese crisis, the Tiananmen Square, 1997 Asian financial crisis, 2001 NASDAQ bubble crisis, 2008 global financial subprime crisis, and you may or may not agree, but it could have happened 2013, it didn't start 2015. This is it in table. Okay, so what do we learn from this table? You would know that bull markets are longer than bear markets. An average duration of a bull market is 4 years, while an average duration of a bear market is only 1.76 years. So if we started around 2013, we're probably almost over. An average, but the bear market average decline is 52%, which we never did. So how would we call ourselves a bear market? We never did a 52% down. An average advance of a bull market is 453%. And this is what skews the advance. I don't know what happened here, and I didn't trade the stock market during this time. 1985 to July 30, 1987, 939 days, it was 1,000% return. From 100 index, I've seen it jump to 1,122.